everyone. My name is Matt Kunzler. I work with Henry Schein Dental. I work as a technology advisor, and today they have asked me to demonstrate the Medit i700 for you. So that's what we're going to do. My son, Colin, not an actual patient. I'm not an actual doctor, but I am able to show you how quick and efficient you can scan in your office for your patients. So a couple things about the Medit. This is the new version. A couple differences to the old one is I am now able to take this scanning tip off, and depending on which arch I'm going to be scanning, I can point it in that direction. What's nice about that is I now have my on-off button in the same place, whether I'm scanning maxillary or mandibular. There are some other nice features to this one. It has a fan, and it prevents the scanning tip from fogging. Key features, you know, with any scanner that you have, you always want to make sure that you're setting yourself up for success. So we want to make sure mirrors are clean and camera lens is clean and you're ready and everything is ready to go before you start. We'll start now with the maxillary arch. So I always get my camera in position before I turn it on, just to prevent any lip or cheek or anything like that from being captured on accident. I also take four paths when I scan. Now, that's a little different than some others, and you could even say I'm not the fastest scanner out there, but one of the things that I do get in the end is a very complete scan. So there's my first pass on the buccal. I've already done the occlusal surface. I've now done one pass on the buccal surface. And now I'm going to do another pass, very parallel. And this is where I'm going to capture all the tissue. That is needed for the skin. This also helps me capture all of the interproximal information and not having to go back in after the fact to capture information I missed. Of course, you can always do that if you miss something. No one's perfect. Okay. And now we'll take a look and examine the scan, see what we got. And right here, you can see, even as I said, I'm not going to miss any of the tissue. You can see I missed some right there. So let's go ahead and capture that real quick. To do that, all I have to do is turn the scanner back on. You'll notice another thing about the way I scan. My hands work together. And so if my scanner is moving, so is my left hand, and that's going to be my retractor. It also works as a fulcrum as I come around the facial side of the camera. So now we have our complete scan, and I am happy with that. So we will move on to the lower. I will also say there is a joystick feature that is with the Medit i700. I personally haven't gotten used to it yet, and so I'm using the mouse. However, there is a feature that you're able to go in and not have to go back and touch the mouse or the keyboard as you're scanning. Just wanted to throw that out there. Also move the tip so that my I'm going to be scanning the lower now, and I get to keep that same. Again, my hands working together, even when I'm kind of scanning this lingual side. I'm still retracting tissue, unwanted tissue, in the cheeks. And if the patient has a frisky tongue, you can always just push that tongue out of the way with the scanner itself. You You can see also I jump around a little bit. Once I have my initial occlusal surface and something to build upon, I can work my way back to front, which I prefer to do. Anytime I can work my way back to front, it's a benefit to me. So there is my fourth pass. Again, two on the buckle and then one on the lingual. And looks like I missed a little bit there. I could always go in and just capture that. Again, no big deal. That's what this is for. We can go in and evaluate. Just make sure we're... make sure we're complete. And now we'll go into the bite. And of course for me, if I'm gonna miss some information, it's gonna be on YouTube, so that's great. Okay, here we go. One bite, oops. I actually made a mistake there, hold on 1 second. There we go, and bite and stay biting. So when I capture the bite, what I'm doing is just making sure that that quadrant is complete, and then allowing that software to pin the bite and give me correct occlusal information. And I'm gonna do it on both sides of the arch. And bite, stay bite. And even though I heard the ding and I know that this is done, I'm still gonna go ahead and scan that quadrant. I feel like the more information you give it, the more accurate of a bite you're gonna get. And so I always scan, you know, about that quadrant. So as you can see, really didn't take a whole lot of time to scan an upper, a lower, and a bite. Patient experience, all of the things that are the benefits of intraoral scanning. I was able to demonstrate that today. If you like the video, please hit like below. You could subscribe to this series, the Henry Schein series, for all of the webinars that we do and the YouTube videos. You'll get reminders about them. Had a great time with you guys today. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a wonderful day.